So last week on the show, we discussed what's going on in Seattle and what happened in Seattle. So Samah Sawant, open socialist on Seattle City Council, big reason why we all heard of the Fight for 15. Amazon didn't like her. Why? Well, for a number of reasons, but the biggest reason being she was a big proponent and a big supporter of the bill that was going to make all the biggest corporations in Seattle pay a fee to help the homelessness, to help homelessness. Now, most of the corporations that would have had to pay this were fine with it. A couple weren't. Among the ones that weren't, Amazon, lo and behold. Amazon made a big to-do about it. They eventually got what they wanted, but they decided that wasn't enough. They really needed to get rid of the Samah Sawant person. So they put $1.5 million, which for Jeff Bezos, that's like the equivalent of like $10 or $15. But nonetheless, it's a lot of money in a local election. They put all that money into Samah Sawant's opponent. What ended up happening? Samah Sawant still won anyway. It came down to the wire, but she still won. And after that happened, they decided maybe this isn't okay that these big companies can really put this much money into our local elections. Maybe we should do something about it. So they put forth a bill to limit the spending of corporations with a foreign print to influence their spending. I don't know why foreign influence was singled out there. I don't know why it just didn't apply to all corporations in general. But nonetheless, it's some good news and it's moving forward. Here's an update from Democracy Now! Seattle bans foreign influence companies from political spending. In Seattle, the city council has voted to ban most political spending by foreign influence corporations in an attempt to obstruct multinational tech companies from influencing local elections. The legislation's author, City Council President Lorena Gonzalez, said the ban could potentially apply to Amazon, fingers crossed, despite the company being based in Seattle, because the legislation will also cover businesses that are substantially owned by foreign investors. In a statement, Gonzalez said, "We have an epidemic of big money in our election, and this step helps to address the appearance and risk of corruption." So that's good news. That's good news that this is happening, and hopefully it does, without a doubt, apply to Amazon. Of course, what is the end game? We want to get all big money out of politics, and we got a long way to go. Citizens United, stuff like that. There's basically unlimited spending corporations can have. We have a long way to go to get all big money out of politics, but something like this is at least a good start. So I'm glad Seattle's moving forward with this. I don't know why specifically it's just foreign influence companies. Maybe that was a way to kind of single out some of the big tech. But either way, I'm glad this is happening. I hope that it without a doubt applies to Amazon, and I'm glad Seattle's moving forward with this. So it's a little bit of a follow-up on something we talked about a week ago, where it looks like they're moving in the right direction. Good stuff. Good on you, Seattle.
Get your news on with Ron. Don't you want to know what's going on? We're getting our news on today. Get your news on with Ron. Don't you want to know what's going on? We're getting our news on today. You can tweet me an article at Ron Placone. We'll go through it together and make it our own. Get your news.